Ladies and gents, my name is Xander, aka Deicide, and in this video, we're going to go ahead and discuss and review this legendary pulse rifle that is by all means the most difficult and the rarest gun to get out of this entire game, and it's called the Redrix's Claymore. By now, I'm sure that many of you Guardians have already heard of this thing, but many of you probably still don't even have this thing, and that's because in order to get this, you have to compete in the competitive playlist, and that is by all means where the sweatiest among the sweaty McSweatsweats congregate, and that, my friends, is why it's so unbelievably difficult to get, not just because of all those players, but also because of the very simple fact that skill-based matchmaking is extremely prevalent, and so it makes getting this Claymore even harder to get. In the competitive playlist, there are a total of 6 overall ranks, and you have to go through Guardian, Brave, Heroic, and then finally Fabled to actually get the Redrix's Claymore. And so once you get to Fabled, which is the 3rd highest rank overall, then you finally can go to Shax and grab this bad boy, no problem whatsoever, and then absolutely annihilate Guardians in the Crucible, because this thing is by all means not just the most difficult weapon to get, but it is an absolute powerhouse that can decimate, eradicate, and truly annihilate just about any Guardian that you guys see in the Crucible. The way in which this Redrix's Claymore emancipates Guardians is exactly what we're going to discuss, and so it does this not just through its amazing TTK, but also through some of its very unique intrinsic perks, and so the only thing left to do is to eviscerate that subscribe button, and let's jump right into the video. As usual, the very first thing that I want to discuss about this Claymore is for you guys to understand the weapon's base TTK, and that's looking at the weapon's damage output for both headshots and body shots. Throughout this entire game footage, you're going to see that this Claymore is doing 29 points of damage in the head and 18 points of damage in the body. Now, if we were to then go ahead and associate these two things with an optimal headshot and body shot TTK, the optimal headshot on this weapon is going to take exactly 6 critical headshots and 1 body shot, which is then going to correspond to a 1.0 second optimal headshot TTK. Looking at body shots and body shots only, this thing is then going to take 12 body shots, and that's then going to equate to a 1.94 second body shot TTK. Averaging these two things together by taking 1.06 and 1.94 and dividing by 2, the overall average time to kill on this weapon is 1.5 seconds, and that is almost identical to that of the overall average time to kill for the Vigilance Wing or for the Graviton Lance, and so in this regard, the Claymore as a base weapon and its base damage output is very, very competitive with other meta weapons in this game. Now, the beautiful and wonderful thing about this Claymore is that it's actually got 2 unique and intrinsic perks that work in tandem together, because as soon as you proc one, you're going to proc the other, and those 2 perks are then going to be able to increase the weapon's TTK even further, and so what those 2 perks are is Outlaw and Desperado. As you guys can see right there, Outlaw states that precision kills greatly decreases the reload time, while Desperado states that reloading while Outlaw is active increases your rate of fire. My friends, having Desperado on this kind of weapon is so unbelievably powerful because it increases the weapon's rate of fire to 600 rounds per minute. Now, just to kind of put this into perspective for you, something like that of a Time War Inspire or Darkest Before or anything else in the higher rate of fire pulse rifle archetype only has a rate of fire at 540 rounds per minute. Thus, this Redrix's Claymore has a rate of fire at 600 rounds per minute, which is even faster than the highest rate of fire pulse rifles in this entire game. Now, when Desperado is active, you're still going to be doing that exact same damage output of 29 points of damage in the head and 18 points of damage in the body, and it's still going to take the exact same number of critical headshots and body shots associated for the optimal headshot and body shot time to kills. Where things are different is, like I said from before, is that rate of fire. And so when you take this into account, the optimal headshot time to kill becomes 0.6 seconds, while the body shot time to kill becomes 1.1 seconds. Yes, my friends, you heard me right. I said that when Desperado is active, the optimal headshot time to kill on this weapon is at 0.6 seconds, and that within itself is truly phenomenal and stupendous and marvelous in so many ways that I can't even begin to describe you as to how powerful that really is. Essentially, what this means is that regardless of whether or not you're getting headshots or body shots, your time to kill is most likely going to be less than 1 second. And whenever you have a weapon that has a time to kill that's less than 1 second, it is one of the most powerful weapons that you can possibly ask for. And if you were to get my humble opinion, when Desperado is active on this Redrix's Claymore, it is by all means the number one weapon in this entire game, hands down. It can beat a Graviton Lance, it can beat a Vigilance Wing, it can be an Antioch D, it can be a Last Hope. It's not going to matter because that kind of rate of fire with that kind of TTK is truly the definition of an eviscerating machine. Now I'm going to be very honest with you all, and that is when Desperado slash Outlaw is not active, the weapon is just mediocre at best. It's the only way in which it becomes this absolute monstrosity of the beast is when Desperado is active in conjunction with Outlaw. If you happen to get a kill without proccing Outlaw, you're not going to proc Desperado even after you reload. And so in this regard, you've really got to make sure that you guys are landing those critical headshots, because if you're not, you're not going to proc Outlaw, and thus you're not going to proc Desperado. However, the wonderful thing about Outlaw and Desperado is that Outlaw now is going to proc every single time that you get a critical headshot. And so this is something that's a buff to Outlaw as a whole, and so regardless whatever kind of weapon that has Outlaw on it, Outlaw is always going to proc and there's absolutely no cooldown. In correlation with this is that Outlaw approximately has 5 seconds for you to be able to still proc it after you get that critical headshot. Essentially what this means is that you don't have to reload instantaneously and then have to find the next guardian. Rather, what you can do is you can wait that time duration and wait to reload until you actually see a guardian. And the wonderful thing about Desperado is that you still approximately have 7 overall seconds to have another guardian kill before it then resets and doesn't proc anymore. You have a 12 second time frame to then go get one guardian kill and then the next guardian kill if you happen to proc those two things and spread them out across for Outlaw and Desperado respectively. 12 seconds is a lot of time to find a guardian, and so in this sense, proccing Outlaw with Desperado and finding the next guardian is not a problem, but rather it's your health. And so many times, I happen to find myself going from one engagement to the next, and by the time that I have Desperado and Outlaw active, I'm already weak, and so that's why I highly recommend that you guys try and do this time duration thing, where you then are able to go ahead and get your health back and still have Desperado active, so that you can truly obliterate the enemy guardian just like that in almost half a second flat. Having said all this information, I think that you guys now have a very solid understanding as to how the weapon functions with and without Desperado in terms of the weapon's rate of fire at 340 rounds per minute for having that base TTK, and then having the weapon's rate of fire increase with Desperado to 600 rounds per minute and how that optimal TTK is so unbelievably powerful. Now the next thing that I want to discuss is the weapon's base stats. And so among all these weapons' base stats, once again, the most important things here is range, stability, aim assistance, and recoil direction. Because range is going to dictate as to how much damage fall off that you can have, as well as the weapon's stability, aim assistance, and recoil direction are then going to correlate into having a marvelous symbiotic relationship for the weapon shot rhythm, so that you guys can land more of those critical headshots, which is absolutely vital for you guys to have, especially with the Claymore. As you guys can see right there, the weapon's range is at 60 out of 100, its stability is at 59 out of 100, has an aim assistance that's fairly low at 39, and a recoil direction that's pretty darn good at 75 out of 100. Having that range value at 60 out of 100 is exactly where the weapon needs to be at, and that's because it doesn't matter where you are in the map, whether you're close up in someone's face, or even if you're at cross map distances, the damage fall off is very minute, if anything at all. And so in this regard, you don't have to worry about range as being a factor here, because that range is more than sufficient to damage any guardian that you can possibly see. What this weapon lacks is that aim assistance, as it's only at 39 out of 100. But despite this, it still has a very good shot rhythm because the weapon's stability at 59 and the weapon's recoil direction at 75 easily makes up for that difference in lack of an aim assistance. And so with this, the weapon still has a fantastic shot rhythm that you guys can understand and grasp very, very easily. And once you get the hang of that, I guarantee you that you're going to be proccing Desperado and Outlaw very, very frequently. And with that comes obliterating guardians. The only real other downfall that this thing has is the weapon's handling speed and reload speed. And as you guys can see, the handling speed's only at 38 out of 100, with a reload speed only at 44. Now the reload speed you're not going to have to worry about too much, and that's because as long as you're proccing Outlaw, you're going to get that instantaneous reload speed anyway. The only real problem here is the handling. And so if I were to have on a masterwork for this weapon, I'd easily go for the handling, as that's going to greatly increase the weapon's aim down sight time, or you could possibly still go for range, as that's definitely going to help you as well, because range is then going to increase the weapon's aim assistance, and of course, increase the weapon's overall damage fall off at longer distances. Now that you guys kind of got a sense of the weapon's base stats, and all the pros and cons associated with those base stats, you've got to be able to understand how you can increase these pros and cons, and that's through the weapon's barrel attachments. As you guys can see right there, the weapon's got chambered compensator, coarse grain rifling, and polygonal rifling. Of all three of these perks, the one that I'm using on this weapon is by all means polygonal rifling, and that's because I really want to have a great recoil direction so that my recoil direction is only vertical, or at least as vertical as possible, and that's then going to allow me to get more critical headshots, so thus I can then go ahead and get that faster TTK, while at the same time proccing Outlaw and thus Desperado to continuously proc them from one Guardian to the next. The very last thing that I want to say about the Claymore is that this thing is a little bit weak in those close, up-in-your-face engagements, or possibly like something like a Last Hope, or something like that of the 18 Kelvin, or anything else along those lines is going to cover it, no problem whatsoever. That's why I would highly recommend that you guys use one of those weapons for those close, up-in-your-face engagements, but for every other kind of engagement that you guys can think of, in those close, mid, and far-range, as well as cross-map engagements, the Redrix's Claymore easily has you covered. All in all, if I had to say whether or not this weapon was good, bad, or neither, I would say that it's phenomenal when Desperado is active, but when Desperado is not active, it's just mediocre at best. With a very, very skilled hand and getting those critical headshots, this thing is going to reward you 110% of the time, but when you don't have that, it's a high-risk, high-reward weapon, thus the definition of a double-edged sword. As a base weapon, it still can compete with the Graviton Lance along with the Vigilance Wing, but is it going to win the majority of the time? Most likely not. The weapon is both mediocre, while at the same time being phenomenal, and so it really just depends on how comfortable that you are with the weapon, as well as the overall health that you have after that first engagement, because those two things could by all means determine as to how efficient that this thing can be for you. After taking all these things into account, I want to hear your guys' thoughts on this thing down in the comment section below, and you can guarantee that I'm going to read all those comments, and I'm really looking forward to hearing to exactly what you guys have to say, whether you think it's awesome, whether you think it's terrible, whether you think it's OP, or whether you just think it's mediocre, because everyone's opinion is always valued, especially on this channel. Lastly, go ahead and check out some of my other new videos, as you guys can see right there on the screen. If you happen to enjoy this one, then you're definitely going to enjoy those as well. That's pretty much all I've got for you as of right now, and so as always, Deislayers, great gaming, until next time.